I'm going to call this regularly scheduled meeting of the Minneapolis City Council to order. Clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember Wright.
Here.
Bender.
Here.
Glidden.
Here.
Yang.
Here.
Johnson.
Here.
Quincy is absent. Warsami.
Present.
Goodman.
Present.
Frye.
Here.
Palmisano.
Present.
Gordon.
Here.
Kano.
Here.
President Johnson.
Here.
There are 12 members present.
We have a quorum present. Councilmember Quincy's on city business. Next item on our agenda is adoption of the agenda. Any changes or additions? I see Councilmember Frye.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I'm going to move to amend the agenda to include under the order of new business a notice of intent to introduce an ordinance restructuring the annual pollution control billing fees.
Councilmember Frye has made a motion to amend the agenda to, it's been seconded to include a notice of intent to introduce an ordinance restructuring the annual pollution control billing fees. Any discussion on that motion? Seeing none, all in approval, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, that carries. Next item then is the motion to adopt the agenda as amended.
So moved.
Any discussion? Seeing none, all in approval, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, that carries. Next is acceptance of the minutes of the adjourned session of December 9th, 2015 and the regular meeting of December 11th, 2015.
So moved.
Any discussion? Seeing none, all in approval, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, that carries. Next, we have referral of petitions, communications, and reports to the city officers to the proper committees and departments. Any discussion? Seeing none, all in approval, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, that carries. The reports of the standing committees are next, and the first is Committee of the Whole, and that committee is chaired by the Council Vice President Elizabeth Glidden.
Thanks, Madam President. We have one item. This would be approving the appointment of the Chief Administrative Law Judge Tammy Pust as presiding officer for the required public hearing regarding designation of a community action agency for the city of Minneapolis, and I'll move this item.
Councilmember Glidden has moved the Committee of the Whole report. Any discussion on that item? Seeing none, clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember Reich.
Aye.
Bender.
Aye.
Glidden.
Aye.
Yang.
Aye.
Johnson.
Aye.
Warsami.
Aye.
Goodman.
Aye.
Frye.
Aye.
Palmisano.
Aye.
Gordon.
Aye.
Kano.
Aye.
President Johnson.
Aye.
There are 12 ayes.
That report is adopted. Next, we have Community Development and Regulatory Services, and that committee is chaired by Councilmember Goodman.
Thank you, Madam President. The Community Development and Regulatory Services Committee is bringing forward 14 items for approval this morning. Items 1, 2, and 3 are land sales. Items 4 and 5, I'm going to pull for amendments. Item 6 is our regular liquor business and gambling license applications. 7, 8, 9 are license settlement conference resolutions. Item 10 is the redevelopment of the property at 4414 Humboldt Avenue North, which is giving us some rescissionary rights over the property if Hennepin County and the developer fail to perform. Item 11 is an MOU with the Park Board with regard to the next steps on the Upper Harbor Terminal. Phase 1. Item 12 is approving a redevelopment plan in the Bassett Creek Valley area in the Harrison neighborhood. 13 is making some modifications to the Common Project TIF district for the Lake and Nicollet redevelopment plan. And item 14 is an extension of contracts for emergency and non-emergency boarding. With that, I'll move items 1 through 3 and 6 through 14, holding off on items 4 and 5.
Councilmember Goodman has moved the bulk of the Community Development Regulatory Services Report 1 through 3 and 6 through 14. Any discussion on any of those items? We'll hold off items 4 and 5. Seeing none, oh, I'm sorry, Councilmember Frye? Okay. Seeing no further discussion on those items, clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember Reich.
Aye.
Bender.
Aye.
Glidden.
Aye.
Yang.
Aye.
Johnson.
Aye.
Warsami.
Aye.
Goodman.
Aye.
Frye.
Aye.
Palmisano.
Aye.
Gordon.
Aye.
Kano.
I'm sorry, could you clarify the items we're voting on?
The voting on items from the CDRS agenda is items 1, 2, 3, and 6 through 14.
Okay. Yeah, aye.
President Johnson.
Aye.
There are 12 ayes.
That report is, those items are adopted. On item 4, Councilmember Goodman.
Item number 4 is the long-awaited land sale of the Nicollet Hotel Block to United Properties. The committee moved this forward without recommendation. There's been a lot of work that's happened since then, and I'm going to move an amendment by Councilmember Frye, which is in front of you, cited CDRS committee number 4, a motion by Frye.
We have in front of us CD item
Number four.
Number four, okay.
As amended with the amendment in front of you.
Okay. Do you want to speak to that, Councilmember Goodman?
Councilmember Frye will speak to it.
Okay, Councilmember Frye.
Thank you, Madam President. The motion is to amend the term sheet containing the terms of the land sale and redevelopment contract for the property, 33rd Street South to United Properties. This is the Nicollet Hotel Block parcel. As many of you know, we had issued an RFP about a year ago. The RFP was won by United Properties, and there were several different changes, both involving market factors, as well as the loss and gain of a residential developer, the loss and gain of a hotel operator, and which resulted in somewhat significant changes to the design. And the design that was put forward, which was really just a massing study, but showed a building that was not quite up to par. In the interim between the CDRS meeting and today, there's been significant work done by United Properties as well as ESG, the architect, and I am extremely pleased with the direction we've gone. So the pushback has resulted in a substantially improved building, a beautiful public realm, as well as connectivity from Hennepin to Nicollet, and even lighting on the building. So things are looking much, much better, and I'm happy to move this motion forward, making the approval of the term sheet contingent on a final approval of the design.
Excuse me.
Happy to answer any questions as well.
Any questions for Councilmember Frye? Seeing none, on Councilmember Frye's amendment, all in approval say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? That carries. Then on item four, land sale, clerk call the roll.
Councilmember Reich.
Aye.
Bender.
Aye.
Glidden.
Aye.
Yang.
Aye.
Johnson.
Aye.
Warsami.
Aye.
Goodman.
Aye.
Frye.
Aye.
Palmisano.
Aye.
Gordon.
Aye.
Kano.
Aye.
President Johnson.
Aye.
There are 12 ayes.
That report is adopted. On item five, Councilmember Frye. Councilmember Goodman, excuse me.
Thank you, Madam President. Item number five is the rental license dwelling revocation of Mahmoud Khan. This is an issue that had a quasi-judicial public hearing in front of the CDNRS committee on Tuesday. I'll remind members of the council that it takes a lot to revoke a rental license, and our policy is such that if you have two rental license revocations, you are subject to potential revocation of all the licenses that you hold in the city. That was the issue in front of us, not the two licenses that have already been revoked that I believe were unanimously voted on by previous councils and this council. This was the latter issue of whether or not the rest of the licenses should be revoked. We're moving forward with the committee's recommendation to revoke the licenses, but I do have an amendment and I'm going to read it out loud. Councilmember Frye moves to amend the action to include that the rental license revocation actions be stayed pending the resolution of any diligently pursued appeals. I'll just explain that what happens next is the applicant has the right under the law to appeal this to the Court of Appeals. And so that means no one will be immediately evicted. The appeals process and the court process will have to play out first. We've only had this happen one other time that I can recall in my 20 years on the city council. So it's a very serious issue. And we took it very seriously in committee, which was chaired by Councilmember Frye. Hopefully folks have had an opportunity to look at the record. It's approximately 5 inches thick. There were over 1,000 violations in various properties. And I think the case was fairly clearly made. So I will move the Councilmember Frye amendment with regard to the revocation stayed pending the resolution of appeal, as well as the main motion.
Councilmember Goodman has moved the Councilmember Frye motion to amend the action to include that the rental license revocations actions be stayed pending the resolution of any diligently pursued appeals. Any questions on that? Seeing none, I'd like to ask the city attorney a question. Ms. Siegel, does Mr. Khan have the right, if he would pursue appeals on this revocation, to ask for a stay on his own? A stay of whatever you call it, to eviction of the tenants, I guess, on his own?
Madam President, since it's the council that's the ultimate decision maker here on the record, he would not have an alternate source to ask for that stay. It's not like a district court proceeding where you could go to the, you know, if you don't get your stay at district court, you could go to the Court of Appeals. The Court of Appeals is a court of review here, but the city council sits as the district court. So it is an action that I think is in the jurisdiction of the district, of the, not the district court, the city council.
Okay. I guess my concern was I don't want us to be doing this lawyering for him. Seeing as how this process has been going on for around 5 years. It's a very, very frustrating process for the people that live in his properties that are poorly maintained and neighbors that have to put up with it. So I find this very, I'm glad to understand what we're doing here. Thank you. Any further discussion then on Councilmember Frye's motion? Seeing none, all in approval say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That carries. Then on the item as amended, item 5, revoking the rental licenses, several addresses, 42, it looks like 42 properties. Clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember Reich.
Aye.
Bender.
Aye.
Glidden.
Aye.
Yang.
Aye.
Johnson.
Aye.
Warsami.
Aye.
Goodman.
Aye.
Frye.
Aye.
Palmisano.
Aye.
Gordon.
Aye.
Kano.
Aye.
President Johnson.
Aye.
There are 12 ayes.
That report is adopted. With that, we've dispensed with community development. On to health, environment, and community engagement, and that committee is chaired by Councilmember Gordon.
Thank you, Madam President. The Health, Environment, and Community Engagement Committee will be bringing 7 items forward for approval. The first is the approving the appointments and reappointments to the Minneapolis Advisory Committee on People with Disabilities. The second is approving appointments and reappointments to the Minneapolis Public Health Advisory Committee. The third item is passage of a resolution recognizing the City Council as the Community Health Board for the City of Minneapolis. The fourth item is accepting grants from the Food and Drug Administration for voluntary National Retail Food Regulatory Standards Program. The fifth is authorizing a contract extension with ClearCore USA Inc. for Lead and Healthy Homes Outreach. The sixth item is passing a resolution delegating authority to the Commissioner of Health to enter into cost share funding agreements as part of our green business cost sharing program. And the final item is authorizing an agreement with Ellingson Health Consulting to provide health policy and program consulting services for the Healthy Living Program. And I will move all 7 items forward for approval.
Councilmember Gordon has moved the Health, Environment, Community Engagement Report. Anyone want to pull anything off or discuss any of those items? Seeing none, clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember Reich.
Aye.
Bender.
Aye.
Glidden.
Aye.
Yang.
Aye.
Johnson.
Aye.
Warsami.
Aye.
Goodman.
Aye.
Frye.
Aye.
Palmisano.
Aye.
Gordon.
Aye.
Kano.
Aye.
President Johnson.
Aye.
There are 12 ayes.
That report is adopted. And next, we have the Public Safety, Civil Rights, and Emergency Management Report. And that committee is chaired by Councilmember Yang.
Thank you, Madam President. Today, we have 6 items for approval. The first item is a Community Engagement Coordinator grant acceptance from the Joyce Foundation. Second item is that 2016 National Forensic Science Improvement grant acceptance from the Department of Public Safety at the state. The third item is a Police Bike Cops for Kids program grant awards from Cerise Conlon and Edward J. Phillips Family Foundation. Fourth item is authorizing a correction for an adult DWI court grant acceptance from the 4th Judicial District. Fifth item is a forensic interview services contract with Corner House. The sixth item is a bomb disposal units joint powers revenue agreement with the state of Minnesota. And Madam President, if I could just comment briefly on item number 3, and I just want to give a shout out to the 2 officers that are part of Bike Cops for Kids who are here, Officer Mike and Officer Dave, right in the back there, for just the great work that they've done to do this program, but also just the great work that will be done with regards to this truck. Thank you.
Councilmember Yang has moved Public Safety, Civil Rights, and Emergency Management Report. Any discussion on those items? Seeing none, clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember Reich.
Aye.
Bender.
Aye.
Glidden.
Aye.
Yang.
Aye.
Johnson.
Aye.
Warsami.
Aye.
Goodman.
Aye.
Frye.
Aye.
Palmisano.
Aye.
Gordon.
Aye.
Kano.
Aye.
President Johnson.
Aye.
There are 12 ayes.
That report is adopted. Next, we have the Transportation and Public Works Report, and that committee is chaired by Councilmember Reich.
Thank you, Madam President. The committee forwards 15 items for approval today. Item one is the 2016 resurfacing program project designations and setting of public hearings. Those locations and dates are listed. Item two is the 7th Street North reconstruction project from 1st Avenue North to 2nd Avenue North. And this is approving the ability to do the layout and the authorized negotiation for private property owners for acquisition and execution of easements as needed. Item three is the contract amendment with White Company Incorporated for stormwater pump station rehabilitation project. Item four is the maintenance use easement agreement with Walker Art Center for Vineland Municipal Ramp, and that's to allow us to proceed with that project. Item five is the 3rd Avenue South redesign project variance agreement, and that's a passage resolution holding the state of Minnesota harmless in granting a variance for the reconditioning of 3rd Avenue between 1st and 16th Street South. Following items are referred to the Ways and Means Committee. Item six is the storm pump rehabilitation and upgrade project, temporary easements for that project. Item seven is the agreement with Ryan Companies for East Downtown Pedestrian Road Improvements. And these are improvements they've done and we will reimburse them for our agreement. Item eight is the contract with Hennepin County for waste disposal services. And that will be from a period from January 1st, 2016 to December 31st, 2017. And the rate will be $55 per ton. Item nine is the master funding agreement extension with Metropolitan Council for the Nicollet Central Modern Streetcar Project. And that'll extend through this year. Item 10 is the contract amendment with Kramer North America for the Burnham Road Bridge over Cedar Lake Channel project. And the amount for that is listed. The contract amendment with IPS is item 11 for the single spaced parking meters. That'll be through December 31st, 2018. Item 12 is the bid construction for concrete sidewalk curb and curb gutter alleys and drive approaches. And that will be with Concrete Idea Incorporated for this year. Item 13 is the bid for Fridley Filter Backwash Supply Tank and Supply, and that'll be with Landmark Structures for the amount stated. Item 14 is the bid for Rip Wrap Materials, and that'll be a single bid from Dresser Trap Rock Incorporated. Item 15 is the bid for Washington Marquette Sanitary Sewer Rehabilitation Project, and that will be accepting the low responsive bid of Meyer Contracting Incorporated for that project. And with that, Madam Chair, I move all items as stated for approval.
Councilmember Reich has moved the Transportation Public Works Report. Any discussion on any of those items? Seeing none, clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember Reich.
Aye.
Bender.
Aye.
Glidden.
Aye.
Yang.
Aye.
Johnson.
Aye.
Warsami.
Aye.
Goodman.
Aye.
Frye.
Aye.
Palmisano.
Aye.
Gordon.
Aye.
Kano.
Aye.
President Johnson.
Aye.
There are 12 ayes.
That report is adopted. Next, we have the Ways and Means Report, and that report will be given by Councilmember Glidden.
Thank you, Madam President. We have 11 items. The first is some changes to our ethics code ordinance, amending regulations relating to trust and accountability. The second item is settlement of a lawsuit of Chi Tao against the city of Minneapolis. The third item is a contract amendment relating to the Convention Center Railing Enhancement Project. Items four and five are acceptance of bids on two different projects. Item number six is authorizing request for proposals for architectural and engineering design services for the 27th Avenue Northeast Storage and Maintenance Facility Project. Item number seven is adopting a Minneapolis defined contribution retirement plan as restated effective October 1st, 2015, and some related authorizations. Item number eight is a contract termination with Ardent Technologies for solid waste information system support and maintenance. Item number nine is an IT gift acceptance for February for a conference registration for February 2016. Item number 10 is authoring an extension of the SecuroNet contract for surveillance network services. And item number 11 is accepting a contribution of $2 million from the Vikings to the city of Minneapolis for the downtown East Commons project, and authorizing execution of amended and restated charitable pledge agreement. And I believe that is it. I think we will have some comment on item number 11, but I will go ahead and move all 11 items.
Councilmember Glidden has moved the Ways and Means report. Any discussion on any of those items? Councilmember Bender.
Thank you, Madam President. I wanted to briefly comment on item 11.
Okay, why don't you go ahead?
Thank you. We had some discussion of this at Ways and Means, and obviously I'm very supportive and grateful for the contributions that are coming in for the Commons and for the work that the mayor and Councilmember Fry and others are doing to make sure this project is a success. I was glad to see that within this charitable contribution agreement, we have built in a percentage, which is between 17 and 23%, I believe, for maintenance and operations of the park. I think every time we talk about the Commons, though, there is an elephant in the room, which is our agreement with the Metropolitan Sports Facilities Authority, which gives away an enormous amount of time and use of our what is supposed to be a public space for private use with no compensation to the city. I predict that the day will come, and probably soon, that we will be asked to contribute more public tax dollars to this space for the operations and maintenance of this space. And I cannot imagine anyone here supporting one more penny of public dollars going into this without a renegotiation of the MSFA contract. That's my position. And I think that is a reasonable one, considering how much public dollars have already gone into this. And again, the absolutely enormous amount of time and other sort of concessions that have been given to a private entity with no compensation back. So, and again, I'm not saying anything I think that others would disagree with. I just wanted to make that very clear as this opportunity has come to discuss the issue again.
Councilmember Fry.
Thank you, Madam President. Generally speaking, I do agree with Councilmember Bender's sentiment regarding the stadium use, I'm sorry, the Commons use agreement. This item, however, is acceptance of money, $2 million that has been donated by the Vikings. First, I would like to say a thank you. Basically, we, you know, in terms of looking how parks are run in the city, every single neighborhood park is 100% publicly subsidized. And if you look at many downtown parks throughout the country, they are privately subsidized. Our downtown park, the Commons, is in many ways a morphing of the two. And with that morphing, it's necessary to do quite a bit of public relations, quite a bit of explanation, as well as extensive negotiating. So right now we're approximately 50% of the way to the $22 million goal. Councilmember Bender is correct that approximately 25% of all revenues contributed are being put in a separate bucket that will go to initially pay for operations and maintenance. But we are also having successes along the way too. Notwithstanding a very demoralizing loss by the Vikings this last weekend, negotiations have actually a roadblock that was previously there has since been released. And we now know that one extensive days that would have otherwise been taken by a soccer team will not be taken, since we're not going to get one. Number two, it was anticipated that the day of Vikings games, the day before, as well as the day after, would be occupied at least on one of the two blocks for placement and removal of a tent. Now the tent will be permanently placed on the medical examiner's parcel block, which will have a long-term lease, hopefully with Hennepin County. And that should open up the space for public access, use, and dramatically cuts down on the number of days that are held specifically by the Vikings. I do agree that there is a strong desire to amend the present contract to ensure more public time. And I do think we have the levers to pull to facilitate that renegotiation. So the public is seeing the sausage being made in this instance, and that transparency is necessary. At the same time, I think we're really on the way to an extraordinary downtown space.
Councilmember Gordon.
Well, I appreciate getting the update on this. I do believe that in last year's budget process, we actually did a staff direction so that staff would look at amending the use agreement around the commons. And it sounds like we've made significant progress on kind of the general ideas and ways we could maybe open up more of that common space for us. So I just wanted to put in my encouragement that we continue and make that formal within the agreements. And I think that would be significant if once we have people on board with that. It'd be good to bring it back for formal approval by the council, and then it's clear to everybody about what's going to happen at the commons once it's up and running and being used. Thank you.
Any further discussion? Seeing none, clerk, call the roll in the Ways and Means report.
Councilmember Reich.
Aye.
Bender.
Aye.
Glidden.
Aye.
Yang.
Aye.
Johnson.
Aye.
Warsami.
Aye.
Goodman.
Aye.
Fry.
Aye.
Palmisano.
Aye.
Gordon.
Aye.
Kano.
Aye.
President Johnson.
Aye.
There are 12 ayes.
That report is adopted. Next, we have the Zoning and Planning Committee report. That committee is chaired by Councilmember Bender.
Thank you, Madam President. We have 7 items from Zoning and Planning this cycle. Item number 1 is granting an appeal for a fence height variance at 2012 Cedar Lake Parkway. Item number 2 is granting an appeal on behalf of Wells Fargo for a parking variance varying the maximum allowed parking at 1505 West Lake Street. I'm sorry. Actually, we're continuing that one cycle. So I'll come back to item number 2, but I will be moving to postpone item number 2 in order to give time to meet item number 2 under the condition for that agreement to be in place for the publicly available parking. Item number 3 is a certificate of appropriateness granting an appeal for several conditions on 112 East Hennepin Avenue, the Nye site. Item number 4 is approving an application for a rezoning at 528 University Avenue Southeast to establish a 5-room hotel, so rezoning to C1. Item number 5 is approving the landmark designation for 404 West Broadway. And item number 6 is denying the designation application for 410 West Broadway, which is a really interesting older building, but just was not in good enough condition for the HPC and staff to recommend its designation. Item number 7 is approving an application for rezoning at 2929 University Avenue Southeast for a mixed-use building there, and that would be rezoning to C3A and removing the industrial living overlay district. So again, I will move items 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7 for approval, and then move to postpone for one cycle item number 2.
Councilmember Bender has moved the zoning and planning report with a motion to postpone item 2 for one cycle. Any discussion on any of those items? Councilmember Yang.
Thank you, Madam President. I'd like to pull item 6 off for discussion.
Okay, we can pull item 6 off. Any other questions or concerns about any of these items? Then let's vote on the zoning and planning report with the exception of item 6. Clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember Reich.
Aye.
Bender.
Aye.
Glidden.
Aye.
Yang.
Aye.
Johnson.
Aye.
Warsami.
Aye.
Goodman.
Aye.
Fry.
Aye.
Palmisano.
Aye.
Gordon.
Aye.
Kano.
Aye.
President Johnson.
Aye.
There are 12 ayes.
That report is those items are adopted. On item 6, Councilmember Yang.
Thank you, Madam President. I wanted to take a moment to acknowledge the hard work of everyone who's been involved in making these decisions. Our HPC, our wonderful group of volunteers, and a constituent of mine actually serves on there, Constance Fork. And I appreciate the hours of study that she and the others have put into this. And, you know, I also want to give an enormous shout out to Jim Vohl for the work that he's done. He spent a good year and a half studying the IOFF and the White Castle buildings. And I imagine Jim is now an expert on White Castles in general. Jim is a wonderful staffer, and you know, I am very thankful for that. In the middle of 2014, I actually wrote the application for the landmark designations for 404 and 410 West Broadway to be considered for designation as historical landmarks. For 404, we just took a vote on that. Thank you, Council, for designating that as a landmark. With regards to 404 and 410, but specifically on this matter of 410, I was then and I am still deeply concerned about any tear down to the structures and replacing them with a parking lot. West Broadway is the river from which good things flow on the north side, and when it is healthy and strong with places for people to shop and work, it builds up the north side. Just seeing this eventually be demolished, I mean, just does it makes me feel sad for the place. And you know, while I understand the situation and why the HPC and zoning and planning has decided to deny the application for 410, the former site of the White Castle and diner, I will not be supporting the decision. I stand with Constance Vork and the minority of the HPC in saying that this building is significant and its rehabilitation would add more to the north side than its demolition. And I just wanted a quote from the Minnesota Historical Society with regards to this parcel of 410. And so 14 is the White Castle building, and it says here, White Castle number 7 is historically significant as an early example of a White Castle restaurant opening during the first year of the franchise's expansion from Kansas to Minneapolis and coinciding with the company's period of greatest growth in 1927 to 1930. The building is associated with broad patterns of cultural development in Minneapolis. This particular White Castle is the oldest remaining restaurant in Minneapolis and is the only remaining white enamel brick building of the 13 that were originally built in Minneapolis. So I just wanted to point that out just to say, you know, I think this is quite significant. And, you know, I understand, you know, the conditions. It might be on its last leg, but it still has a leg. And so, you know, I would ask for people to reconsider on this. Thank you.
Any further discussion on item number 6? Seeing none, clerk, call the roll.
Councilmember Reich.
Aye.
Bender.
Aye.
Glidden.
Aye.
Yang.
No.
Johnson.
Aye.
Warsami.
Aye.
Goodman.
Aye.
Fry.
Aye.
Palmisano.
Aye.
Gordon.
Aye.
Kano.
Aye.
President Johnson.
Aye.
There are 11 ayes and 1 nay.
That item is adopted. Next, we have the introduction and referral calendar. Excuse me. And the first is an introduction pursuant to notice by Councilmember Glidden to introduce the subject matter of an ordinance amending the code relating to air pollution and environmental protection, or first reading and referral to Health, Environment, and Community Engagement Committee, clarifying the standards of acceptable energy data and stating the schedule of public disclosure of the received data. Any discussion then on that introduction? Seeing none, all in approval say aye. Aye. Opposed? That carries. And next we have a PERC dry cleaning resolution ordinance. This is a motion by Councilmember Andrew Johnson pursuant to notice to introduce the subject matter of an ordinance amending the code relating to licenses and business regulations, laundries and dry cleaning establishments for first reading and referral to the Health, Environment, Community Engagement Committee prohibiting the use of certain solvents and amending enforcement provisions. Any discussion on that introduction? Seeing none, all in approval say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? That carries. Next we have, pursuant to notice, Councilmember Bender is moving to introduce the subject matter of an ordinance amending the code relating to the zoning code for first reading and referral to the Zoning and Planning Committee, amending regulations related to inclusionary housing. Any discussion on that introduction? Seeing none, all in approval say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? That carries. Next we have resolutions, and we have 3 resolutions. We have the first is the MS Awareness Week Honorary Resolution, recognizing the National Multiple Sclerosis Society's Awareness Week in Minneapolis. Any discussion on that resolution? Seeing none, all in approval say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? That carries. Next, we have a resolution honoring the 2015 Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Essay Contest winners. Any discussion on that resolution? Seeing none, all in approval say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, that carries. And next we have a motion, resolution, excuse me, amending the standing committee membership resolution. And it is basically a swap. Councilmember Warsami is going to move from the Public Safety Committee to the Intergovernmental Relations Committee, and Councilmember Quincy will replace him on the Public Safety Committee. Any discussion on that resolution? Seeing none, all in approval say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, that carries. Next we have new business, and the first is a notice of intent from Councilmember Goodman to introduce at the next regular meeting of the City Council the matter of an ordinance amending the code relating to the housing appeals, amending the membership and process processes of the Housing Board of Appeals. That notice is given. Councilmember, next is a marijuana decriminalization ordinance. Councilmember Fry and Councilmember Andrew Johnson give notice of intent to introduce at the next regular meeting of the City Council the subject matter of an ordinance amending the code relating to health and sanitation drugs, removing marijuana from the list of prohibited drugs. That notice is given. Next, we have a motion by Councilmember Gordon to return to author the subject matter of an ordinance amending the code relating to the housing maintenance code, adding provisions for the licensure and regulation of emergency shelters. And Councilmember Gordon sent an email to all of us explaining the need for that action yesterday. Any discussion then on that motion? Oh, I'm sorry, there's two items here. Councilmember Gordon also is giving notice of intent to introduce at the next meeting of the City Council the subject matter ordinance amending the code relating to health and sanitation, adding a new chapter, emergency shelters, adding provisions providing for the licensure and regulation of emergency shelters. So on those two items, the first is a motion by Councilmember Gordon. Any discussion on that? Councilmember Gordon.
Thank you, Madam President. I think technically number two is just giving notice, so
yes,
we can vote on introduction, mm-hmm, but we need to, yep, vote on number one,
yes,
of that two part.
Okay.
Thank you.
On item one then, under Councilmember Gordon's motion, any discussion? Councilmember Gordon, do you wish to speak? No. All in approval say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed, that carries. Next is the notice of intent, and that notice is given. Next, we have an after-hours permits ordinance. Councilmember Andrew Johnson gives notice of intent to introduce at the next regular meeting of the City Council the subject matter of an ordinance amending the code relating to air pollution and environmental protection, construction activities, amending provisions related to after-work hours permits. That notice is given. Councilmember Glidden and myself give notice of intent to introduce at the next regular meeting of the City Council the subject matter of an ordinance amending the code relating to contracts by adding prevailing wage requirements to certain city contracts for public improvements. That notice is given. And Councilmember Yang and Councilmember Glidden give notice of intent to introduce at the next regular meeting of the City Council the subject matter of an ordinance amending the code relating to streets and sidewalks in general, repealing section 427 entitled Congregating on Streets or Sidewalks. That notice is given. And we have the addition of the restructuring of the annual pollution control billing fees ordinance. Councilmember Fry and Councilmember Gordon give notice of intent to introduce at the next meeting of the City Council the subject matter of an ordinance amending the code relating to, excuse me, amending the code restructuring the annual pollution control billing fees. That notice is given. Any announcements? No announcements. All right. A motion to adjourn then would be in order for the purpose of discussing a security briefing relating to security at City Hall.
So moved.
Any discussion? Seeing none, all in approval say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? That carries. We are adjourned. Thank you.